Ladies and gentlemen, standing here next to the flag of our great nation, I am reminded of the many times that I have recited the Pledge of Allegiance. A great American once impressed upon me that the Pledge of Allegiance is not simply a string of words to be recited each day in school. It is a solemn promise, and each of its 31 words matter. If I may I recite it and try to explain its meaning in detail. Try and remember that I am your school teacher many years ago, and he's trying to explain the pledge. I pledge allegiance. I promise to be loyal and to give my love and devotion to the flag, our standard, oh glory, a symbol of freedom, of the United States of America, 50 states united in a common purpose, and to the republic for which it stands. We don't pledge allegiance to a specific person or group. We pledge allegiance to the great ideals of this country, one of which is that in America, power is invested in representatives chosen by the people. One nation under God. This is a country of all races, religions, and cultures, but we are united as one nation and blessed by divine providence, indivisible, incapable of being divided, with liberty, which is the freedom to live one's own life without threats or retaliation, and justice, where people are treated fairly under the law, for all, which is everyone, you, me, your neighbors, everyone. Will you please now, if you're able, stand with me and let us recite the Pledge of Allegiance all in unison. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. You may be seated.